But yeah, so because we were originally going to cast one match, but unfortunately it got postponed, and then another one got postponed. So here we are in this matchup, and this is the one that just happened to be just starting. We actually had the remake for us right after they finished the pick. So, but anyways, they were nice enough to do so. So here we are. We did get something to cover, and I'll get the information on for you on the screen in just a second. But we are going to have Team It's Ghost, who are going to be taking on Ling's Walkhouse here from Group C play, of course. And currently, we do see Ling's Walkhouse. They're actually 0-2. They were defeated 2-0 by Black Fade. And, of course, Team It's Ghost defeated A-Man 2-0 themselves. And we casted that series. So, obviously, what that pretty much means. Team It's Ghost, sweep here will put them in a very comfortable spot. For Ling, on the other hand, they can manage to squeak out a win here or there, maybe giving them some signs of life and screwing over Team It's Gozu a little bit. So, kind of playing the disruptors here, you could say. But Ziori, of course, you're going to be joining me once again, buddy. How you doing?
Yes, I'm doing well. Enjoying reading some of the fine chat going on amidst some of the rescheduling that you were talking about. So, I saw some people in chat asking about SGTY. Of course, we were planning on TTES versus SGTY, but apparently there's a really handy rescheduling rule for this tournament that some teams are choosing to exercise. Mm-hmm. So that's kind of where we're at, as you said, kind of a long break jumping around. But we do have a game. At least we found a game. It was a remake, and we totally missed banning and picking, but it's something.
We got something, at least. That's what matters. Here we are, of course. So, at least we got some Heroes in here with action again. We get to see Limp again. That's always a cool thing. We get to see Limp on Poliwag Priest again, mind you. So that's going to be a lot of fun. So let's look at the lineups and see what we're dealing with here as far as both sides go. So we'll start with Team It's Ghost. So, of course, again, we obviously missed the bans because of the remake. But, as you know, it's something. So let's all be happy. Zephyr, Poliwag Priest, Nymphora, Ophelia, and Bubbles. So, going with the Zephyr pick here on Team It's Gosu. And, a hero that especially Team It's Gosu has been known to run quite a bit in the past. Not going to be played by Chessie, though. He's just actually going to be played by Haxor in here. Yes. Usually on the other, but Haxor, of course, Chessie playing that Ophelia.
Yeah, that's scary as well. You know, those are Chessie's top two heroes. So, you know, seeing him play Ophelia is no surprise. You know, Haxorin plays a pretty mean Zephyr as well. Haxorin plays pretty much any hero that requires a good bit of farm really well. It seems to be that thing that Haxorin does well. Regardless of the game, he's going to pick up some farm. So I'm sure he'll have a fair time down here in this bottom lane with Nymphora as his lane buddy, and as you mentioned, Ophelia in the jungle. Plenty of healing support to keep him safe and sound. All around, though, fairly interesting lineups. Of course, the Dark Lady here for Ling throws a wrench into the mix a little bit.
Yeah, that's definitely the fun pick to talk about. So speaking of that, Pestilence, Glacius, Torturer, Electrician, and Dark Lady, as you mentioned. This is a fun lineup over here on Ling's Walkhouse. Of course, Cat Lomain and crew. We talked about that, or at least I did when the group selection show. The group drawing show that we did an hour before the matches actually started to see which teams would be in which group. And we mentioned Ling and, you know, Cat Lomain and his crew. They have a little bit of experience in the competitive scene. They've participated in several events, and although haven't won necessarily anything big, at least they have that experience and have gone at least somewhat far in these events. But clearly a tough matchup for them here. But going with a very unorthodox lineup, I mean. There's a Dark Lady Pestilence, though. That's definitely something unique. I will say, though, I'm always a big fan of Pestilence, and I'm really happy to see him here because I think he is underused on the competitive scene. So looking forward to seeing what Cat Lomain can do here on this Pestilence. But the lane's a little bit interesting, especially since Torturer is apparently babysitting for this Dark Lady. Not too often you'll see a Torturer babysitting nowadays, but is doing so here in this game here.
Yeah, that is really interesting for a whole mess of reasons, but the one that just jumps out at me as Torturer is that solo hero needs that experience, as we've talked about many a time in the past. So sharing the experience with Dark Lady, giving Dark Lady some of that solo experience is really going to slow Torturer down. Though we have seen support Torturer a time or two, and it is okay. It's not the worst thing in the world, but certainly a little bit strange. And where is this Pestilence? So Pestilence Glacius in the mid lane here going to be going up against a solo Poliwag Priest. It's definitely good news for Ling's Walkhouse here, as Pestilence, one of those heroes that we've talked about a little bit in the past as well, really requires quite a bit of farm to be super effective. As we see Ophelia, speaking of super effective, doing a hell of a lot of damage to that tornado in the mid lane. So we'll see. It should be good news for Pestilence, though, in that kind of 2v1. Hopefully we can get a nice quick portal key, maybe a Helm of the Black Legion, and maybe take off a little bit in this game.
Yeah. Of course, that combination there with the Shrunken Head portal key, very, very deadly for a hero like Pestilence. So that will be the idea here. But as you mentioned, Ophelia doing a good job of harassing there in that middle lane and coming on over. So Chessy off the bat, playing quite the effective role, is going to take over the Catman champion. Top lane, you do see Torturer really pressuring this Bubbles here and making sure to keep him out of lane. And, you know, this does bring up an interesting thing. It's a case of we never see Torturer played the babysit role nowadays. I mean, there was a phase where actually he was considered one of the stronger supports in the game. Really? Until he actually started playing a solo role, and it seems like more and more teams kind of picked up on that, and then all of a sudden he became just such a dominant solo hero. But yeah, he definitely used to be considered more of a babysit support style hero, and that goes back to the point I'm making of, you know, just because we never see him in that role doesn't mean he's not good at it. I mean, he is fantastic when it comes to support, when it comes to babysitting, as we're kind of seeing here. I mean, the range that he has, the 600 range, as well as all of his abilities, just constant harassment that can put out as far as a very solid stun. Yeah, he can definitely accomplish it. It's just more of a case of he usually is more ideal and better suited for that solo role if you're going to pick him up. But again, nothing necessarily too wrong with Ling using him as that babysit role here.
Yeah, oh no, definitely not anything wrong with it, just unorthodox, so to speak. But speaking of Pestilence here in the mid lane, going to take a lot of damage. The smackdown's been called. That one last auto attack is not quite enough. Going to survive with about 25 hit points to spare. So Polywog Priest kind of dangerously low here, but looks like he's going to be able to survive as Glacius is totally out of mana. But let's take a look at the GPMs here, and wow. Zephyr farming reasonably well, but Dark Lady, well above 300 GPM, free farming up here in the top lane. As you mentioned, Torturer really doing a good job keeping Bubbles at bay, and wow, Mr. Ling is definitely feeling the benefit from that. And just look how much pressure he's putting on Bubbles here in the top lane, doing a hell of a lot of damage and farming very, very nicely. I think Team It's Ghost is going to have to do something pretty soon here to rotate this around, maybe get Ophelia in the Hellborn jungle, something to slow down this Dark Lady.
Yeah, it's sooner than later is going to be the name of the game here for Team It's Ghost to definitely address that Dark Lady and not let her get too crazy by any means. As you kept stating, I mean, her farm very impressive early on in this game. So whether that is a level 6 Poliwag Priest coming up, set up a gank, or Ophelia perhaps roaming up there, or maybe just getting some nice push out of Zephyr and coming together as a team and really forcing the Hellborn team to make some decisions. Whatever the choice maybe. We'll see, but definitely something will need to be done by Team Iskosi to kind of address that Dark Lady. But for the meantime, obviously it's still static pretty much in this laning phase, 4.5 minutes in. Poliwag Priest comes back to the middle lane, but as soon as he does, you see Glacius running up, and there goes the Tundra Blast, but obviously the haste rune activated, and Poliwag Priest will be more than fine. In fact, going back in to harass Glacius and Pestilence as much as possible, knowing that he has a quick getaway with that haste rune. Such a smart play by, again, Limp playing, of course, Poliwag Priest there. Not nearly as dominant as we saw him last time, simply because of the lane setup, but look at Ophelia once again has another Vulture Lord. Gonna go in right here, there's a Hex being applied, and actually Pestilence in a little bit of trouble. Now the Tongue Tag comes out, and the Vulture Lord gonna assist for the kill right there. Limp gets credit for it. Holy crap, it is not too often we see a Vulture Lord's Tornado used in very effective ganking like that, but Chessy has done it several times in this early game, and sure enough, able to get the Bloodlust kill with it.
Yeah, exactly right. I mean, that's just one of those things, you rarely ever see it, but very impressive. I mean, that Tornado does a pretty solid amount of DPS. Unfortunately, we can't look at creep abilities here in the spectator mode. I actually am not sure how much DPS it does, but it's pretty damn dirty. Up here in the top, Bubble's going to be in a little bit of trouble. Looks like he is going to fall to the wrath of Dark Lady and Torturer, and Mr. Ling going to be able to pick up that kill. So now he's above 350 GPM, really in great shape. But yeah, that Vulture Lord.
it is powerful, and again, I'm actually really curious how much, what the exact damage is, but also the slow that it applies. You know, it definitely can be a solid tool to use, but it just moves so slow.
I didn't realize it slowed.
Oh yeah, no, it's definitely a I want to say 10% movement slow. It's not anything really crazy, but it is quite a bit. Again, I don't know the exact number, but it definitely slows as well. So. Definitely another benefit of it. But yeah, Chessy deserving credit there. Meanwhile, though, Poliwag Priest in a little bit of trouble once again with the Hex on the Pestilence. Maybe the same against... Oh, there's our Tongue Tag turned over once again. Limp making some crazy plays in the last second. The Skulls of King New coming in. And there's a holding place. Pestilence gets turned around on once again. Great play from Limp. Excellent support from Chessy. And Glacius may actually be still in a little bit of trouble. Electric Jolt up in 2 seconds. If he gets a creep wave here, it might not even be necessary. There's the Electric Jolt. And Poliwag Priest will get the hero kill. Limp is just on another level today with this Poliwag Priest hero. Unbelievable play by him.
Yeah, exactly right. You know, I was crediting it to just that one game, you know, getting that slightly lucky double tap early on. But, I mean, he is just on fire. Beautifully done, timing that tongue tie right around Pestilence as he was in tower range, did the math, able to survive. Like you said, great support from Chessie as well. So far, he's had a very active Ophelia, sitting 1-0-1 only 7 minutes in and farming around 230 GPM. So Dark Lady right now is the saving grace for the Hellborn team. Everyone else struggling quite a bit, but... Alas, the Dark Lady, the number one farmer in the game, let alone on her team. So it's going to be one of these things where they're putting all of their eggs in the basket of Dark Lady. And if she gets out of control, she can carry this game, but that's a little bit of a slippery slope and puts a lot of pressure on Mr. Link.
Exactly. And, you know, maybe getting that portal key on Calamine here on this Pestilence, and as long as you can get that, then I actually think that the Hellborn team could be in a pretty solid spot because of how well Dark Lady is doing. But... Definitely. You're definitely right to say. I mean, it really is putting all the eggs into one basket for the most part. They're really just going to rely on this Dark Lady's amplified farm that she has early on to just be the big impactful point out throughout this game. Electrician, meanwhile, at the bottom lane, surviving long enough. Is it going to be long enough? The port coming in from Torture, but now Torture realizing he's in a horrible spot on top of this Typhoon that was down now wearing off, but the Cyclone is still doing a lot of damage from Zephyr, and the Gust not even going to be necessary. Oh, it doesn't have enough mana for the Gust. The Zeal's going to be tossed right there by Torture, and that turnaround for Torture, a nice heal pop by Pallet at the last second, but it's not going to matter. Zephyr not able to do enough, and now Zephyr actually in a little bit of trouble. Here comes Chessie with the Minotaur, though, stunning Glacius right there, and look at Glacius, the return damage, the auto attacks Chessie, diving quite far here. What is Team Skulls doing? They're diving all the way to the secondary tower. They will get the kill right there with the Skeleton King, but the Skeleton King will fall shortly after. So at least they get the kill to Glacius. Look at the middle lane as well. As the bottom tower goes down, Poliwag Priest wards are down and applying a lot of pressure in there as Pestilence just ports back. Not going to be a tower kill, but a lot of split pressure right there from our Legion side.
Yeah, it's kind of unrelenting pressure as well. This tower in the mid probably going to fall into deny range here, and maybe not. It's going to be close enough. There it is. So that's really unfortunate. This tower should be able to be denied fairly easily, but yeah, I mean, a nice 2-for-1 down in the bottom, then that tower kill pushing its Ghost pretty far ahead. Up in the top lane, Dark Lady in big trouble. Doesn't have the charging strikes. He's going to use the ultimate, though, to try and micro around a bit. It's not going to last too long, and hopefully they'll be able to get this kill on the Dark Lady. It would be kind of a shame if they... let her get away. She's going to micro down back into the Legion jungle. Bubble's going to shell surf up, and looks like Dark Lady is, going to be able to survive. So some very crafty micro, nice team support from both Catlemagne and Mizukami Glacius there. Keeping him alive, so very well done. I thought Dark Lady was going to be a goner.
Oh, as did I. I mean, I would think we had very good reason to believe that. But no, that was actually just very well played by Dark Lady right there in the end. Going to the Juke's fine. Look at this. The damage coming out. Zephyr dropping quickly. The Swarm's on top, and the heal's coming out, but not going to be nearly enough for both Ophelia and Nephora. Dark Lady barely staying alive herself. Once again with those Dark Blades active, and they get the kill that they were looking for. Need to be careful because Bubble's jumping in. Does he have a kill field? No, he doesn't have a kill field. It is on cooldown. You see the Catman Champion getting frozen right there. And obviously Glacius with that freeze will freeze these minions for quite a while and may actually end up killing it in the end, but well played again by them. Well, they deny the tower. Yes, they will at the last second. Electrician, though, jumped in the wrong place at the wrong time, and he will end up falling, so big-time miscommunication coming out right there from Ling's walkhouse, and Electrician, yeah, poured it into really a suicidal spot, so at least a free kill in the end for Team It's Gozo on top of that, but man, a good initial kill into Zephyr, and Dark Lady stayed alive throughout it all.
Yeah, exactly right. I think that's really the icing on the cake. That Dark Lady survived, they killed Zephyr, and they denied the tower. So if Electrician hadn't really ported to his death, that would have been a very, very good exchange. But alas, he did just kind of honey badgered that bad boy. He really doesn't have too many core items, but he didn't really seem too scared. So at least some credit for some man-ups there from Heartscape. But yeah. Regardless, he did pay the ultimate price. Team It's Ghost, though, man, with a nice lead set up for themselves, about 3k gold. Experience lead non-existent, but 3k gold isn't too shabby. Taking out two cowards, 7-3 hero kills, so that is definitely good news. Up here in the top, Pestilence could be in some trouble. The Kelp Field's been used. It's probably why Priest's going to be able to catch up. He does have a double damage rune activated, and Fora going to port Zephyr up here. And I think Pestilence is going to die, but oh my gosh, he's juking him out. He's in the middle. I think they're going to find him, hopefully.
Are you kidding me?
Is this... Wow.
Whoa, what a juke spot right there.
Look at you.
Everyone needs to remember that juke spot. Wow. They had no clue. They ran by him several times, but I guess you just can't see him. You have to actually go into that pit right there to see him. So well played by Catlomane. Now, will it matter too much in the end? Because we do see the Legion team going to make a push here on the top lane. Glacius, a little bit of pressure. We'll get Gusted back in the quick burst on onto him. In the meantime, though, the Dark Lady ultimate activated is not with the party, though, just yet. Electrician off to the side, but we do see Torture and Pestilence fall. Electrician maybe going to kill an M4 at the very least. But again, Dark Lady wasn't here. Oh, nice here from Ophelia at the last second, actually. And Electrician will get turned around now. So Limp ends up with a hat trick on Poliwag Priest. So when it's all said and done, and the tower kill for that matter, that looked up. That was very, very good for Team Itzkosu. So an awesome juke from Pestilence. But yeah, Team Itzkosu, big push for them. And now Dark Lady needs to be careful right here. She should be able to port away. As yes, she will, so she'll be fine. But her not being there in that fight definitely screwed over the Hellborn team. And you could also say probably they shouldn't have even been there in the first place without
exactly.
her.
Exactly. Yeah, and that's the route that I was going to take. Like, yeah, Dark Lady, you could say, was out of position. But really, it seemed Ling should have just said, all right, we're going to sacrifice the tower. If they push the tier 2, then we'll pose a strong defense instead of doing that sort of almost like impromptu defense where they all kind of ran in one at a time. The ports were staggered. It just didn't end up being a very good engage. Zephyr was able to dive the tower and do a hell of a lot of damage with that ultimate, locking down Torture and also that Pestilence. So, you know, well played by our Legion team, but I think Ling would have been wise to just back off there. Down in the bottom lane, though, Ophelia, you're going to find yourself in a little bit of trouble against this Dark Lady Torture combo. Looks like she's going to be fast enough, though. There's quite a few creeps down here doing a hell of a lot of damage as well. Plenty of mana left on those creeps, and maybe able to try to set this up on the Torturer. He's going to catch that slow. There's the damage from the Vagabond. Is the Skeleton King going to drop the CC? Not quite yet, but uh-oh, there's Nymphora with Poliwag Priest. Looks like they're certainly going to be able to get Torture, and maybe even Dark Lady as well. Dark Lady with no mana. There's the Hex. There's the Tongue Tie. Nymphora just going to do some auto-attack damage. The Smackdown comes. Limp is now dominating, so they clean up both those kills while conceding no deaths themselves. So Poliwag Priest, Haste Rune activated here. Could find himself in a bit of a sticky situation. Going to turn and drop the CC onto Electrician. Trying to keep that Nymphora alive as best he can, and it looks like he's going to be able to do just that. So again, well played by Team Itzkosu, especially this Limp on Poliwag.
Yeah, this is Team Itzkosu, very impressive when it comes to their teamwork this game, and as it was in the first series as well that we saw against A-Man, they're really putting it all together. And we see right here, once again, going to initiate on a Glacius. Electrician gets canceled immediately out of the static grip. Poliwag Priest, whoa, Poliwag Priest, you're almost dead, but there's that Ophelia heal, and the Dark Lady ultimate is activated right now. But Ophelia will not get away. Electrician just a little bit too powerful. Bubble's also taking the damage as well, and he will eventually be locked down. As that started with the Taint Soul right there, but in from behind, Zephyr with that Typhoon plays. Torture dropping quickly to that. He will eventually die. That gust back in on Electrician, and Electrician will die as well. As you see, Darkly, the Taint Soul once again, gonna go for the kill. But at what cost right here? He will jump in, finally takes out Limp right there. First death of the game of 555 bonus gold right there for Darkly. That's actually a pretty big deal, and she will end up living. So that worked out pretty well for Darkly in the end. Again, 8-1-3 Limp, so he was 8-0-3 just before that. But again, that streak ending, that's a lot of bonus gold for Dark Lady right there. But will it be enough? With the way this game is going, it's hard to tell.
Yeah, the strange thing about that fight was Zephyr not really being there. It seemed like that fight would have been kind of easy for Team Itzkosu. Had Zephyr been there from the get-go and maybe could have initiated with an ultimate. By the time he got there, you know, Poliwag Priest was already almost dead. Ophelia was kind of on the run. And I'm not really sure where Haxorin was. I wasn't really looking at him on the mini-map, but he just sort of wandered his way over. You know, didn't port down to the tower, just slowly walked his way over. By the time he got there, it just wasn't enough. He did pick up the double tap, which is good, but you know, it's sort of making an even exchange instead of a, wow, Team Itzkosu comes out ahead again. So sort of, like I said, not sure what Haxorin was doing instead, but I thought he was pushing the tier 2 here in the top lane, but alas, it's at pretty high HP.
Yeah, he is going to go into the jungle. You see the mini-map, some Hellborn heroes are nearby, but not enough to put him in too much danger as they're not looking to go in there. Electrician is going to sit back at this top lane, but I mean, we just keep talking about Dark Lady, and obviously it's been a really an up-and-down game. For the most part, it's been pretty solid, though. But you look at the supporting cast all around. It continues to be pretty abysmal for the most part. I mean, Pestilence is trying his best, but it just really drops off from there. Speaking of Pestilence, he is going to jump on into four right here. The Dark Blades come out, as well as the Charting Strikes. And Dark Lady will help secure the kill right there onto Nymphora. So well played on their part. And now Poliwag Priest actually running right beside a Ward of Revelation. He may be in a little bit of trouble as you see the Swarm was attempted to be applied, it looked like. But Poliwag Priest still on the run. And is he going to be able to get away? I mean, Flight is up in 10 seconds, but I think Poliwag Priest is going to survive in the end. You see Ophelia coming over from the side. And, of course, they'll spot her incoming because of that Swarm debuff. But nice pickoff in that middle lane onto Nymphora as sort of the high that was just purchased by Zephyr. So he just continues to go up and up this game, and Mock Brilliance is on the way for him now early on.
Yeah, that is super, super early on. I mean, he's sitting above 450 GPM. He has those core. I mean, a 60-minute sort of the high is huge. I mean, he's about 1K off or so, 1,200 off, what have you, for that recipe. This tower kill is hopefully going to come his way. No, Blimp's actually going to be the one to grab it. But still, I mean, Zephyr is well on his way to, like, an 18-minute Mach of Brilliance here. That is insane, given that he already has a Helm of the Black Legion, Ghost Marchers, and Mystic Vestment. So Haxorin has, I think, effectively snowballed here. And once that Mach comes out, we'll see it does a hell of a lot. It will do a hell of a lot of damage to everyone on this Hellborn side. Following Priest just now picking up his Portal Key as well, which, as always, is a good pickup, especially this early on. Mm-hmm.
Oh, yeah, him having that Portal Key. This already, I mean, on top of the other items that he has, it's just, again, he is really taking off 390 gold per minute, and that'll be huge with those level 2 wards as well. A ward drop on anyone in this at this point is a guaranteed kill for him. So, and, of course, that Portal Key should allow him to set it up fairly easily. Although it is a lot easier said than done, but these high-skilled players definitely make it look easy, although not, but still, should be easy for him. So, anyway... These players are pretty good, is all I'm saying. I mean, they're better than me. I'm not afraid to admit that. We see right here the Ward of Sight was placed. Now, dude, so kind of worried about Glacius. Going to get a little bit too confident. Out comes X. There's that Ward Trap that we were talking about. The Tongue Tie. Nobody canceled it right there. I don't know if that was his choice or if something stunned him. I think it was his choice, actually, as he was trying to hold on Torture to get another kill. But anyway, they got the Glacius kill. So already up in numbers advantage. Albeit it's going to be up in about 20 seconds. But now they're going to move to this middle lane and look to push that. And won't have wards, of course, but... can still do quite a bit of pressure, as Mach of Brilliance just delivered right there to Zephyr. So they also have that now to work with.
Yeah, that is really huge. You know, like you said, with Polywog Priest, unfortunate with that ward placement. It's great they were able to kill Glacius, but as always, if you can place those wards for a kill and also in tower range, sort of doubling their effectiveness, but it doesn't really seem to matter. Of course, they killed the tower very handily here, and they can engage so easily. Glacius is going to fall yet again. Vestlin's going to run in and get off an okay stun, but he is just going to get dropped in a matter of seconds without those core items, especially that Shrunken Head that we talked about earlier on. Looks like the fight is going to continue here. Polywog Priest actually taking a lot of damage. His Dark Lady seems to have overcommitted a little bit, and she is going to get taken out by a nice aggressive gust there from Haxorin. Pestilence did buy back here. Indeed, he did, trying to get in and make something happen, but he's going to get CC'd yet again. He's just going to fall to all of that AoE damage out from Haxorin, who does pick up the hat trick. So that 20-minute Mach, man, it's just, it's too much. It's so much AoE damage in these huge team fights when they're all grouped up. It's that's the power of Mach and Brilliance. The earlier you get it, the better it is.
Exactly. And, you know, Polywog Priest wants to keep the pressure up, apparently. Goes in with the Hex, but you do see the Conceit Vote coming out right there from our Hellborn team, so it looks like they have had enough. And Team It's Gosu gonna take the first game in the Static 2-game series here. So that means they're defeating them 1-0 now, but they're also a 3-0 overall so far. And that does put them in a very comfortable spot now. Obviously, still three more matches in total to play, including one more against this team, but another victory, as we talked about from the beginning, if they go 4-0, we'll definitely be in a very prime position to move on to the next round. So
if they go 4-0, does that mean that they're guaranteed a spot? I can't do the math in my head, Breaky. Is there any chance of them not making it if they start out 4-0?
No, there's actually not. You're right. If they go 4-0, that, because Black Fae will have to play. Well, they will play A-Man. That got postponed, but. No matter what happens there, it'll either be 1-1 or 2-0. So even if Black Fade manages to go 4-0, then it'll be those two teams moving on. So,
right.
No matter what, they are moving on if they go 4-0. It's just will be a matter of
that can be huge.
Will it be first or second place? And seeding obviously can be a big deal in the quarterfinal. So
that's huge, though.
Yeah.
Awesome.
Yeah, so big congratulations to them again. That's just the first game, though, so we will have the next game coming up. But Ling, you know, now going to be playing from behind, and they are now 0-3 on the other side of the spectrum. A loss here would pretty much secure their spot and not moving on, so to go to the opposite route. So we'll see what happens, though. Looking forward to seeing what happens in the second game. But to wrap this one up, once again, I was Breaking CBK. Joining me was Theory here. And as always, stay tuned to honcast.com for much, much more coverage. The $5,000 Cooler Master Honor Tournament will continue.